Let's get ready to go to bed. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Now for today's video, I thought that I would do something a little bit different. So I don't know about you guys, but after a very tiring, stressful day at work, I like to unwind and in the comfort of really soothing videos. Anything that is cozy and comforting in a day that is filled with a lot of noises and a lot of anxious events. So what I like to do is actually watch a lot of cozy videos while doing my skincare, or I like to watch a lot of nighttime skincare routines. Now, obviously, I'm not a skin expert, and I've actually given up on skincare for the majority of this year already, mostly because we were entering into year two of the pandemic, and I realized that I didn't really need to go out that much, so therefore nobody really had to see my face, like, up close. So it was okay if it was a little bit dry and flaky here and there, as long as the camera didn't really catch it. But now that I'm entering into the winter cold months here in Canada, I can no longer ignore the fact that I need to go back to my skincare routine so that my skin isn't peeling. So I thought that I would talk about my BookTube goals for 2022 and also walk you guys through my skincare routine. So I guess the first thing that I always do to unwind myself and to really feel good about myself is to make a really giant cup of tea. I like to make it super hot, and the teas that I like to drink are the minty varieties, something that tastes like toothpaste. I know it's really weird. Or something that's very soothing and calming and light tasting, like chamomile tea. So the first things that I do want to talk about is, of course, step number one in my skincare routine, which is to start with toner. The toner that I'm using is Time Revolution toner. And Time Revolution is a brand by Misha, which is a Korean beauty brand. And I love Misha mostly because I've used their products and I think they're pretty high quality. So I use toner to start off so that I can just start with a clear base. We're going to be working with thin liquids first, and then we're going to move to the more thicker liquids as we progress in our skincare routine. So I guess the first things that I want to talk about is actually my 2021 BookTube goals that I never did tell anyone. So personally, I set out a goal for myself to gain 10,000 subscribers this year. So I think I ended off 2019 with around 4,500 subscribers, and seeing my growth, I thought that it was definitely possible to get near that number. And then towards the end of this year, I realized that I wouldn't make up for it and I wouldn't have time to make up 10,000 subscribers. So I actually readjusted my goal, and I luckily hit my new goal of 9,000 subscribers within the last week of this year. So thank you so much to everybody who has found me through my recommendation videos, through my friends who promoted me, and through just like a general search on books. And hopefully you guys are enjoying the ride so far. So the second step that we have here is actually this another Time Revolution product called the First Treatment Essence. This is a dupe of SK-II's essence that retails for $300 Canadian. And obviously I don't have that kind of money to treat my skin, but this works really well too. I find that it really helps with the dewiness of my skin and to make sure that I'm absorbing all the creams that I will be later applying to my face. So using the same cotton pad that we have, we can just pour it on and just dab it onto our skin. A lot of people also choose to pour the liquid directly onto their palms so that they're not wasting any of the liquid. But I just have this pad already, so I'm just gonna do it here. I find it also less messy. I think also my new BookTube goal for next year is to create more vlogs, more soothing content and more calming content, because those are the types of contents that I generally like to watch anyways. I know that my personality sometimes is not very soothing and not very calming with my curt remarks and with my snazzy jokes and with my zoom-ins, but I want to have a mixture of both. I want to have a space for my viewers to have a moment to themselves and to also have a good laugh. So I'm going to be working very hard towards creating content that is both funny and also soothing at the same time. So the next step that I have here is actually this hyaluronic acid from The Ordinary. Now, I was very skeptical of using The Ordinary, not because I heard that it was a bad brand, but mostly because the packaging of it looks really scary, and I just don't know if I can handle chemicals and acids to my face directly, because these bottles look like they're from the laboratory, and I got really scared of it, but seeing reviews on Sephora about how using hyaluronic acid and using the Ordinary's hyaluronic acid has really improved the absorption of the liquids onto their face, I was just amused by it. So I decided to buy it and I'm using it right now. It's very sticky and it definitely leaves the face feeling gross, which is why this is not the final step. So in terms of reading goals for next year, I already have a set TBR of books that I do want to read within the next year. In terms of like what types of books that I want to read, I definitely want to dive more into indie romance, mostly because I feel like a lot of BookTube viewers like to read indie romance and I want to break into that market. I want to be accessible to those viewers. I'm all about creating my content to suit the audience of BookTube and also my audience as well. So if you guys haven't noticed, I posted a lot of historical romance content this year because I started realizing that a lot of my subscribers loved historical romance and it wasn't a job for me when I was doing those historical romance recommendation videos because I loved historical romance too. I still love it, but I don't want to be just known as like the historical romance reader here on BookTube, but also just like a romance reader in general that reads traditionally published romance, indie published, and also historical romance too as well. So I recently started using retinol, and this isn't a comment to my age saying that I'm not even that old and yada yada yada. I'm 26 years old. I don't think I'm that old yet, but I also know that with skincare, we have to start fresh and we have to start early or else it's gonna be too late for us to kind of reverse back time. Retinol is used for anti-aging and to prevent aging, I guess. And so one night I spiraled and I bought retinol off of Sephora. And it's the Ordinary brand once again, but I bought the 1%, and you're not supposed to use really high retinol, especially when you're a first time user of retinol, because there's a lot of like side effects to retinol. So I've been using it very sparingly since I bought such a high percentage of it. But one of the side effects is definitely peeling of skin and drying of skin. So I've already used retinol twice this week, so I'm gonna skip on my retinol routine, but I will definitely use it in the next week or so to make sure that I'm keeping up with my skincare and that I'm keeping up with renewing my skin. So I guess the next step would be using an ampoule. So this is once again a Time Revolution ampoule. Honestly, I used the other ampoule before, and I don't know the benefits of this ampoule, but I just wanted to have more vitamins, nutrients on my skin. Another goal of mine is to also continue with BookTok, I know. So I've created a BookTok this year, and it was actually an idea because I didn't want to fall behind the times with social media. I guess I can consider myself a social media influencer, and I always try to keep up to date with the trends, and BookTok literally like took up everybody's minds for 2 years now. I think it started probably in 2019, and it was only in 2020 did I realize that it was a big thing. And publishers started realizing that BookTok is really influencing readers, and readers are choosing what books to read based off of BookTok. Suddenly we have books that have been published from, you know, a decade ago, running up to the bestsellers list because of BookTok. And I didn't want to fall behind on the times. I wanted to create a BookTok account too, so that publishers still see me as someone relevant for influencing books. I know, it's like one of those deepest scares that I have, is that I become irrelevant to my publicist and then them going like, we can't send you books anymore because you suck. So I started BookTok as a joke, and then I made a video about it. And that video didn't really take off, but it's fine. I enjoyed the process. I kept the account and I continued to use that account to watch my memes. The types of memes that I watch are corporate memes. Corporate memes are my favorite, chef's kiss. Other memes include the low quality, you know, stupid memes that nobody laughs at, but it's really funny at 2 a.m. So just a quick segue, the next step that I'm gonna use is this really beat up nutrition serum from Its Skin. So I've used it a lot already. As you can tell, this container is empty. And we're just gonna squirt some onto the palm of our hand, a considerable amount. I just like to use my finger and swipe it on my face and make sure that everywhere is covered. I give extra attention to under my eyes too as well, because I know that's like where signs of aging start. And then we also can't forget the neck, because that's also where signs of aging start too as well. But going back to BookTok, I started it, I stopped, and then now I'm going back to it. I'm keeping it active. I think I'm trying to find the style that works for me. I'm trying not to get too discouraged from the lack of views that I get on BookTok and not deleting them and getting embarrassed of them, because I know I have a couple of friends that know me in real life that follow me on that account, and I don't want them to think that I'm a loser for acting out weird scenarios. The style that TikToks that I'm making right now include corporate memes, because that's just how I feel like a meme at work. And then also BookToks in general, because hello, I'm trying to be a good book influencer. So I'm gonna try really hard to continue BookTok and hopefully not mentally drain myself from creating all this content. So the next step that we have is the eye cream. So we're almost there. It comes in a fancy little tube like this, which makes it very easy to apply. I just apply it to a finger and then I just swipe it underneath my eye. I don't watch a lot of like skincare videos, like from skincare experts, but I know that a lot of people have been criticizing eye cream and have said that it's all just more concentrated face cream and it's just fluff. I don't know if it's true or not, but I'd rather just protect my eyes right now so that I don't get wrinkles around here earlier than expected. And then another goal of mine for BookTube is to actually just create reading vlogs. I like vlogging sometimes because I like showing aspects of my life, and I think it'll be like a nice challenge to have to create something interesting. I know a lot of people love reading vlogs. It's something comforting that I definitely watch, and if you like the BookTuber, it's something to look forward to as well. I have a lot of BookTubers that I watch religiously for their reading vlogs. Like, I love looking into their lives and seeing what they're doing. I love how comforting it is that we don't have a set schedule of what the video is going to be about, and it's just a day in my life and I'm just kind of going through the motions with them. I want to have like less structured videos where I'm kind of just sitting in front of the camera and just like spewing out things, because I find that, you know, spice is life. Let's spice it up a bit. Let's make things interesting. Let's shake things up. Okay, so the last thing that we're gonna do is to really just apply face cream. So the face cream that I'm using is this Collagen Nutrition Cream from It Skin. It's another Korean brand, and I forgot if I mentioned this already, but it's a Korean brand that I found at my local like store for very cheap, and It Skin's a pretty popular brand too as well. So apply generously to areas where you feel like are very dry. Another thing that I want to change up with my BookTube channel is the aesthetics of my BookTube channel. So I think that I've done a pretty good job with my thumbnails. I think they're very pretty, in my opinion. Maybe you disagree. They're very colorful, they're very vibrant, they're very eye-catching, they're very like maybe like children like advertised, because usually children like channels are usually this colorful and vibrant. But I want to switch it up a bit. I want to make myself a little bit more sophisticated. I want to go a little bit muted tones. I want to, you know, work a little bit harder on making my thumbnails a little bit more aesthetic. But catch me next year, end of year reflection of these goals, and all my thumbnails still look like they belong in a kindergarten classroom. But anyways, that is it for my skincare routine as well as my bookish channel goals. I didn't really talk about my bookish channel goals. I just reflected on my life, but hopefully you enjoyed this like little chatty with me before you go to bed, and hopefully you have a good night's rest of sleep. And I'm not going to bed now because I don't sleep at all. Like, I sleep at 2 a.m. so I'll be probably watching a lot of TikToks before I get any shut eye. But you should go. You should sleep. I'll see you guys again later. Bye. I also forgot to put on chapstick because my lips are so dry.